guys, in today's video, we're going to be talking about my top 5 picks for top mods on your daily driver. Daily driver, what kind of vehicle am I talking about? Now, it doesn't matter if you're driving like a $1,000 car or a $50,000 pickup. This is going to kind of apply to everyone. Now, I'm just going to give you a bit of a background how I like to use a vehicle. I use my vehicle to and from work. It does the occasional once in a great while it tows, but mostly this pickup carries the odd thing. So the mods that I'm suggesting are mainly for convenience, a little bit of safety, and overall satisfaction, because if you think about it, your daily driver needs attention. You spend the most time in here, and I see a lot of people don't put like any kind of mods in it to make the experience more pleasant, but you're driving to and from work. What, the average person drives, what, 30 minutes to 45 minutes on average, some people more, some people get stuck in traffic for quite a bit of time, and you also have to use your vehicle in different climates. Like here we're in Canada, so we have winters below 0 degrees Celsius, and we get pretty hot summers in my books, you know, above 30 degrees Celsius. So we have to kind of make our vehicles comfortable in all these climates and also perform well. And for me personally, I think you should enjoy driving your vehicle. If you're going to drive your car, if it's like, you know, a boring car or a sports car or a 4x4, whatever kind of vehicle it is, I really think you should enjoy your driving experience, and hopefully these mods will help you guys get there. Now remember guys, this video is for extra mods. We're talking about things to make your daily more fun. These are not essentials. You do not need to put these things on your vehicle besides the safety items that we go over today. Wheels and tires is a great place to start. Wheels are the focal point of the vehicle, and it makes or breaks a vehicle. It's also the number one safety device because the tires are the only thing that touches the ground. I prefer to run two sets, one for summer that you can see laying on the ground, and my winter set for colder climates. Winter tires are great in the rain and also for winter because they're very soft compound compared to the Goodyear SRAs that I like to run, which are more of an all-season tire. But the downside to running winter tires all year round is they would wear out really fast, so that's why I run two sets. For brakes, I like to run stainless steel braided lines. The main reason is because when you're driving in hot summer months or for extended periods of time, rubber lines may tend to want to expand, so having a better brake pedal feel is a big must for me. It's still the same as a regular brake line. You just have to keep in mind that on the outside is the stainless steel braided, which prevents the hose from expanding over time. I've had these in the truck for 8 years, and they've been serving me really well. For rotors and pads, I do spend a bit more money, so I like to run power slot or power stop rotors, just slotted type, and I like to run ceramic pads, and I typically buy the Akebono pads because I find it's a good match, and they're relatively inexpensive to buy. There are also designs like this, which are supposed to provide the same benefits as a slotted rotor, where the gas has somewhere to escape, and it also, in theory, would also help clean the pad as it cuts away at it. The downside of slotted rotors, I would say, is one, yes, they are more expensive to buy, and I guess your pad life would go down a bit because you are cutting to the pad. I didn't really notice like it cut my pad life down a ton, and I prefer to do something slotted over the groove like this as opposed to cross-drilled, because I feel like depending on the rotor manufacturer, if they don't use a good steel or a good tough material, that you compromise the strength integrity of the rotor. Now, there's a lot of misconceptions when it comes to rotors. If you feel like you just need to go on a budget, there is absolutely nothing wrong with stock style rotors. If anything, they're the strongest because they don't remove any material at all. Cross-drilled, I just think they look cool, and they're probably just better in rainy conditions because the water has somewhere to go. If you're looking for a high performance rotor, I would just go slotted, honestly. For my intake, I do a hybrid of aftermarket and factory, and I've now gone back to a factory style box, but I run a high flow reusable filter. Typically I run a K&N in here. Say what you will about K&Ns, I have this truck up to 190,000 kilometers, no issues. I think it really depends on people on how they service those filters, if they don't clean them properly. If you're really worried about it, after maybe 3 cleanings, just go ahead and dispose of it, or you can keep running it, because there are quite a few vehicles documented with high mileage running them. If you're really worried about it, just run the stock cotton style. But over here on these trucks, I removed all the baffling. I'm not a big fan of the baffling because all it does is it's not smooth for the airflow to go through, and all it's designed is to keep the intake more quiet. I honestly didn't hear this intake get any noisier, so this aerated MIT tube fit the bill perfectly.
exhaust is another big one for me. I love listening to the sound of a motor, but at the same time, I don't like it to be obnoxious. I personally prefer brands similar to Magnaflow or Magnaflow itself. One, they're built very durably. You get a natural sound from the motor, and they tend not to be that loud. Batteries are another place besides tires I never cheap out on, so I always like to run some sort of high quality battery. In this truck I have an Optima Red Top. I prefer the Red Top for daily use. I tried the Yellow Top and I've talked to a bunch of professionals, and we all seem to agree that the Yellow Top is not a good daily driver application. It's good as a secondary battery. The Red Top has more cold cranking amps and can be recharged a lot easier and quicker than the Yellow Top. Another brand you might want to check out is North Star. We're trying this now in two of our dailies and we have gotten very good experiences with them, mainly on the startup. I couldn't really tell, like with the stereo systems running, I couldn't really tell a difference, but definitely during startup, the cars turn over a lot easier. These things have huge cold cranking amps. And if you also look at how they're constructed, it's very high quality because on the top post terminals, you can see that they're made out of brass compared to other manufacturers of batteries. Upgrading grounds on the motor and throughout the chassis is a big one for me. This is more of like preventative maintenance. Having proper grounds in the vehicle makes sure all the electronics work properly. Tint is another big one that I don't see a lot of people really talk about. You can see on the driver's door and on the windshield, the driver's door is just slightly different. This is the lightest tint I could put on the front of the vehicle. Now you have to check with your local laws because most people don't allow you to have tint on the vehicle, but at least you can tint the back. You can always do that. And also you can add a brow to the top of the windshield. Now, why do I like to tint my windows? One, you get a little bit extra privacy, but two, the main thing is a lot of daily drivers are parked outside. And if you're parking your vehicle outside, the interior gets hit by a lot of UV light. That's what really kills interiors, is that those UV rays. And depending on the manufacturer, some interiors will wear out faster than others. So by putting tint on, one, the vehicle's gonna be a lot cooler when you get in on those summer months, and it's also gonna last a lot longer. For safety and convenience, you really can't beat a remote starter with security system. Having a remote starter is nice. How I use it is I let the motor run for about a minute. So as I'm getting all my stuff, as I leave the condo, I hit the remote starter. So by the time I get down, the motor has been cycling for about 30 seconds to a minute and we have some of the fluids going so I can just drive away. It is very bad for a vehicle just to get in the car, start it up, and within 10 seconds just drive off. You really have to let those fluids circulate. Now, I don't recommend you over idle the vehicle. That's not going to do any good either. That is going to be extra wear because you're not really shooting the oil anywhere and you're also wasting a lot of fuel. So how I like to use my remote starter is just 30 seconds. If the vehicle is parked outside for a long time, yes, I might run up to 10 minutes, but that's very rare. So now the truck will run for about 15 minutes unless I tell it otherwise, and or if I get in the vehicle and drive away, it shuts down, or we can just shut it down manually. We also have full security on the vehicle as well, so if anything were to happen, like if the glass were to be broken, shock sensor, it has a mobilizer on top of the factory mobilizer, it's harder to steal, and also GPS tracking. These are all things that you can add on to it, which is nice when you're dealing with a vehicle but that doesn't have a lot of features to begin with. The truck didn't have power door locks, so I had to add that in myself, and those are the one things I can't live without is keyless entry. Now, having a sound system is very important to me. You can see in my other videos that I go over the breakdown of the sound system in this pickup. Everyone likes music. I don't care who you are, you like music of some sort. It's fair to say. So if you're going to spend lots of time in a vehicle, having a sound system is very important. Now, if you were to do this on a budget, you can have a factory head unit. If I were to break this down, I would say at the very least get a monoblock and a subwoofer. If you want more, change out the speakers as well, or step up to a 5-channel, amplify all the speakers, and you can also add a sub. Or if you want to go all out, change out the head unit speakers, add 2 amps, and a subwoofer. The main thing though is if you get that little bottom end from a subwoofer, you're going to hear about 30% more of the sound from your music. Switching over your bulbs to LEDs is another big thing for mine, because it's one of those things you're not going to have to service as much because they last for such a long time, and I also think they're safer as well. You can see on the truck that when the parking lights are on, they stay white, and as I signal, they'll go amber. The nice thing this is, the other side stays white, so looking at the truck from the front, you can totally tell which way I'm signaling because only the side that I'm signaling turns amber. They also last a very long time. Like I said again, these lights have been on this truck for 8 years and no issues. Install was a bit tricky on certain vehicles depending on the lighting system because my DRLs might backfeed through the brake lights, so I had to add diodes, and I also had to add load resistors as well to prevent hyperflash. Here's one thing that I don't think anyone ever talks about, and I keep forgetting to talk about my videos, so this makes sense to add it in, are floor mats. Yes, floor mats. If you drive a vehicle in the winter, what happens is, or even where it's really rainy, you track a lot of water in. So, you know, you dust off your feet, and then there's snow all over your boots, gets off into the floor mat, and then, well, as you warm up the car, it starts to melt, right? And then the next season, or springtime, you're like, why does my car smell so funny? Well, what's happening is, the carpet's getting soaked, and it's just trapping all that. So what you wanna do is you wanna get a floor mat, preferably the molded style, because they're easy to clean. But see this design? See how it comes all the way over here? Well, as the snow melts or there's water getting tracked in, it just comes off and it drips out. As opposed to other floor mats where they're on the inside of this, well, that just gets trapped all in here and it just gets wet. And if you have carpeted floors, it just smells over time. This will make a huge difference on how long your interior lasts, and it smells really. Well guys, those are my top picks for daily driver mods. So we went over a little bit of bolt-ons with intake, exhaust, mainly safety for tires and brakes, and we had convenience and entertainment with the remote starter and security system and the sound system. These are the things that I think if you were to spend any amount of money on a vehicle, those are the things I'd focus on. Keep in mind though, this is only worth it if you're going to keep the car for at least 4 years. If you're one of those people that likes to change cars because you get bored every 2 years, I'm going to say you're going to be spending too much money outfitting the vehicle every single time. You might as well try to find a vehicle that's maybe 3 years old that has those things factory. It won't do it as well as this vehicle does, but at least you'll have it. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram and Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca. Yeah.